You might be wondering why everyone's talking about Linux. What is it? There are two answers to this question. The first is the correct answer, and that is, Linux is the core of an operating system. It's the essential software components which coordinate hardware, software, and user interaction. We call this the kernel. The second answer is a bit more vague. When some people say Linux, what they're talking about are Linux-based operating systems, or in other words, operating systems built around the Linux kernel. So what is a Linux-based operating system? We usually call them Linux distributions, or distros for short. A typical Linux distro consists of the following. The Linux kernel, the core of the operating system. This usually includes most drivers, though not all. GNU tools and libraries. Command line utilities that allow for quick, easy usage and management of the system. The package manager, the way the operating system manages software installation, updating, and removal. Documentation, text documents which explain how software works and each application's various features. Usually a desktop environment, which is software that enables you to use your computer with a mouse and generates a graphical user interface. And finally, user applications, things like word processors, web browsers, and everything else. There are so many different Linux distributions out there. You might have heard of Ubuntu, Fedora, SteamOS, Arch, and others. Why are there so many Linux distributions? Well, that's a great question. The simplest answer is that because both the Linux kernel and software for Linux is free, anyone can make their own Linux distro to suit their tastes. And that's really what it boils down to. The Linux ecosystem is all about choice. You get to choose how you want your computer to behave, you get to choose what software comes pre-installed, and you get to choose how your desktop looks and what key combinations do what. Linux is up to you. With great choice comes great responsibility, but only if you want it. There are a ton of options out there for those who are uninitiated. Ubuntu and Linux Mint come to mind. These distros are designed for a comfortable end-user experience, foregoing the complicated initial setup that prove too high a hurdle for the average user. But the advantages of Linux, even Linux with proverbial training wheels, is enormous. Linux is free, both in terms of cost and in terms of freedom. You can do whatever you need to do without asking the gatekeeper's permission. Linux is stable. Blue screens of death just don't happen in a Linux environment. There are no registry errors, and things just seem to work without complaint. Linux is secure. Within the Linux world, it's pretty hard to find yourself victim to viruses or other malware. Linux is versatile. Ever wonder what OS your cable or satellite box is running? It probably is running Linux. How about your phone? Many old and new phones are powered by Linux as well. How about fancy cars or even fancier refrigerators? You guessed it, Linux. Linux is cool. The Raspberry Pi runs Linux, and so does this rad PC-powered arcade cabinet. Valve's new gaming-specific operating system? Linux. And I'd call that a checkmate. Over the next couple of months, I'll be creating a series of videos aimed at explaining Linux, basic concepts like the terminal, the file system, and the difference between native and non-native games. If you've got an idea for one of these videos, you can share it down in the comments or tweet at me at @TheLinuxGamer. And if you liked what you just watched, you can share this with your friends. While you're here, you can check out some of my other videos, and don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this from me, the Linux Gamer. Thanks for watching.